إن الحمد لله تبارك وتعالى نحمده ونستعين به ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله تعالى وخير الهدي هدي سيدنا محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وما قل ودل خير مما كثر وألهى وقليل يغنيك خير من كثير يطغيك وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين وبعد Dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, today inshallah we have 6 pieces of advice from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to one of his honored sahaba, Sayyidina Abu Dharr al-Ghifari radiyallahu anhu wa ardah. Sayyidina Abu Dharr, like the rest of the sahaba, he used to love the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam so much. To such an extent, sometimes if he is in his house and he remembers him, alayhi salatu wassalam, he can't wait until he goes to him and looks at his face and talks to him and seeks from his guidance, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And that's why he used to describe Rasulullah as my Khalil. And there is a difference between Khalil and Habib. Habib, if somebody loves another person, he calls him Habib. But if he loves him so much and he cannot wait until he looks at his face and speaks to him, we call him Khalil. So Sayyidina Abu Dharr radiallahu anhu has reached that level in the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَقَلْ أَوْصَانِي خَلِيلِي بِخِصَالٍ مِّنَ الْخَيْرِ. My Khalil, my most beloved one, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, has given me some pieces of advice. Number one, قَالَ أَوْصَانِي بِأَنْ أَنْظُرَ إِلَى مَنْ هُوَ دُونِي وَلَا أَنْظُرَ إِلَى مَنْ هُوَ فَوْقِي عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ. The first one, he said, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam advised me, he asked me to look to those who are inferior to me, and not to look to those who are superior to me, who are better than me in this worldly life. Because if you want to be content, if you want to be satisfied with the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on you, that we actually cannot count, you have to practice this and to train yourself, because it's not easy. It goes against our human nature that when I see somebody who has better car than my car, I start to compare myself to him and I say, why don't I have the same car? If somebody has a better house, a better wife, better children, better job, I start to compare myself to him, and that way I will never be satisfied and content. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looks at our hearts and he finds out that we actually are not content with the ni'am that he has granted us subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will not be happy with this. He will not be pleased with this, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that's the first advice, to train ourselves. But when it comes to the religious good deeds, anything that relates to the Akhirah, we're supposed to compete. In many ayat in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ. Hasten towards the forgiveness from your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Surah Al-Imran, in Surah Al-Hadid, سَابِقُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ. And in some other places in the Quran. This is the first advice from Rasulullah to his sahabi, Abi Dharr radiallahu anhu, and to the rest of the Muslimin after him. The second advice, which I think is the most important for us today, قال أبو ذر رضي الله عنه وأوصاني رسول الله بحب المساكين والدنو منهم وهي أهمهم على الإطلاق. Some people in our world nowadays die out of hunger, out of diseases, all around the world. And if you look in our community, we still have people who are in need, who deserve our zakah, who deserve our sadaqat. Sayyidina Abu Zar radiallahu anhu says, the second advice from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not only to give the people who are in need, not only to help them. He said, بِحُبِّ الْمَسَاكِينَ وَالدُّنُوِّ مِنْهُمْ, which is, he asked me to love the poor and to get closer to them. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Can we do that? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked An-Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam to make this beautiful dua after every prayer. Nabi alayhi wa sallam saw Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his dream. An-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his dream. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to him, Ya Muhammad, إِذَا صَلَّيْتَ فَقُلْ. When you pray, after the prayer, make this dua. اللهم إني أسألك فعل الخيرات. Oh Allah, I ask you to help me to do righteous deeds, خير. وترك المنكرات. And to avoid the evil things. Number three, وَحُبَّ الْمَسَاكِينَ. After every prayer, oh Allah, help me, grant me love towards the poor, the people who are in need. وَأَن تَغْفِرَ لِي وَتَرْحَمْنِي. And to forgive me and have mercy on me. وَإِذَا أَرَدْتَ بِقَوْمٍ فِتْنَةً فَاقْبِضْنِي إِلَيْكَ غَيْرَ مَفْتُونَ. And if there is a calamity that is going to strike a people, please take my soul to you without being affected with that fitna, with that calamity. And then he said, وَأَسْأَلُكَ حُبَّكَ. And grant me love towards you. وَحُبَّ مَنْ يُحِبُّكَ. And grant me love towards those who love you. وَحُبَّ عَمَلٍ يُقَرِّبُنِي إِلَىٰ حُبِّكَ. And grant me love to the righteous deeds that draw me closer to you. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This dua is actually full of love. As you can tell. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, after teaching the Sahaba this dua, he said, إِنَّهَا حَقٌّ فَادْرُسُوهَا وَتَعَلَّمُوهَا. It's actually a truth. So try to learn this dua and to teach this dua to one another. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The poor people, the people who are in need, will enter the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 50,000 years before the wealthy people, as he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because the people who are in need, they have nothing to be asked about. But the wealthy people have a lot of money, a lot of wealth, and Allah will ask them about every single cent before they are allowed to Jannah, insha'Allah. Number three, the third advice from Rasulullah, قال سيدنا أبو ذر وأوصاني أن أصل رحمي وإن أدبرت. And the Nabi عليه الصلاة والسلام asked me to keep the ties, to be kind towards my relatives, even if they don't like me, even if they adbaru, even if they turn their backs towards me, they don't want to see me, they don't want me to go visit them. If I go visit them, if I call them, I don't feel I'm welcomed. They're not interested in coming to visit me. But that's the exact meaning of being wasil, of your rahim. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ليس الواصل بالمكافئ ولكن الواصل الذي إذا قطعت رحمه وصلها. That's the exact meaning of wasil, the one who connects with his ties, who keeps and remains the ties with his relatives, is the one when his rahim is being cut, when they disconnect with him, he starts to make wasl, he starts to connect with them, try to call them, he tries to be kind towards them, he tries to give them gifts. And if you continue doing this, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم to the Sahabi who had the same problem, and I'm kind towards them but they don't like me. قال النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام فكأنما تسفهم المل. If you continue doing the same thing, it's like if you're actually humiliating them. And in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you're the one who will be asked, because you're mukallaf. We are mukallafun. You don't have to care about them, how they react. You just have to do your role and to play your role and to do your part. As he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The next two pieces of advice from Rasulullah to Sayyidina Abi Dharr are similar to each other, and they fit the personality of Abi Dharr radiallahu anhu. Number 4 and 5. قال سيدنا أبو ذر وأوصاني أن أقول الحق وإن كان مرا. And the Nabi عليه الصلاة والسلام asked me to say the truth no matter how sour it may be. And number 5, وأوصاني ألا أخاف في الله لومة لائم. And he asked me never to be afraid of criticism of others or blame of others when it comes to matters of truth and defending the truth. This is the personality of Sayyidina Abu Dharr radiallahu anhu. That's why he was against Muawiyah radiallahu anhu in his conflict with Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu. And when Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu was chosen for the Khilafah, Sayyidina Abu Dharr was against this because he loved Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu so much. And his opinion is Sayyidina Ali deserved the Khilafah more. But Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu taught Abu Dharr a lesson. Your love towards me doesn't allow you to go against the truth. And Sayyidina Ali gave bay'ah to Sayyidina Abi Bakr himself radiallahu anhuma wa an Abi Dharr. He didn't used to care about feelings of others when it comes to truth radiallahu anhu. And that's why Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, Ya Abu Dharr, innaka ta'ishu wahidan. You will live in this world alone by yourself. وَتَمُوتُ وَحِيدًا. And you will die by yourself alone. وَتُبْعَثُ وَحِيدًا. And you will be resurrected alone. رضي الله عن أبي ذر. So it teaches us, when it comes to the truth, I think there is something in the truth, I have to read the whole religion as one sentence. One word in this sentence says, when it comes to the truth, you say the truth without being afraid of blame or criticism from others. And the other word in this sentence says, أُدْعُ إِلَى سَبِيلِ رَبِّكَ بِالْحِكْمَةِ وَالْمَوْعِظَةِ الْحَسَنَةِ. You say the truth with wisdom and the nicest way ever that you can present the truth in. But we don't present the truth and create problems and cut our relations and ties with our brothers in Islam, and then we claim that we are not afraid of blame of others. That's how we read Islam. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن والاه. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم. The last advice from رسول الله to سيدنا أبي ذر, he said to him, وأوصاني أن أكثر من قول لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله فإنها كنز من كنوز العرش. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam asked me to increase and to frequently say, there is no power or mighty except by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because this word, لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله, is one of the treasures of the treasures of the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One time Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam was traveling with his sahaba, and among them was Sayyidina أبو موسى الأشعري. يقول سيدنا أبو موسى فكنا إذا صعدنا كبرنا وإذا نزلنا سبحنا. We were with the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, and whenever we go uphill we say الله أكبر, whenever we go downhill we say سبحان الله, and we used to raise our voices. We're walking with him عليه الصلاة, traveling with him. فقال النبي أربعوا على أنفسكم فإنكم لا تدعون أصما ولا غائبا. Just lower your voice. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not deaf and is not absent. Even if you whisper, He will hear you subhanahu wa ta'ala. أربعوا على أنفسكم. Come down. Lower your voice. قال سيدنا أبو موسى الأشعري فقلت في نفسي لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. He was saying لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله and whispering to himself, and nobody can hear him at all. Traveling with the Sahaba, nobody hears him. He's just whispering to his own self, saying in his nafs, to his own self, in his mind, لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. وكان في مؤخرة الرحل, يعني المسيرة, يعني. سيدنا أبو موسى, he was at the end of the army of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, or the Sahaba of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, or whatever parade they were in. Then Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم called him from the beginning and said, يا أبا موسى, لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله كنز من كنوز العرش. He said, يا أبا موسى, say لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. It's one of the treasures of the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How did he know صلى الله عليه وسلم? Did he hear him? He was whispering to himself. He was at the end of the parade. The Prophet was at the beginning. But it's a revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of his miracles, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You don't have to justify it. He's a prophet, alayhi salatu wa sallam. So, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah is an important word to say, insha'Allah ta'ala. So, just to end our khutbah, insha'Allah, 6 pieces of advice from Rasulullah to Sayyidina Abi Dharr. Number one, he asked me to look at those who inferior to me, and not those who are superior to me. 2, to love the poor and to get closer to them. 3, to be kind towards my relatives. 4, not to fear the blame and the criticism of others when it comes to the truth with wisdom. 5, to say the truth no matter how sour it may be. And the last one, to say لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. أقول قولي هذا وإني داع فأمنوا. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد في الأولين, صل عليه في الآخرين, وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. اللهم علمنا ما جهلنا, وانفعنا بما علمتنا, وزدنا يا ربنا علما. اللهم اغفر ذنوبنا, واستر عيوبنا, وتول أمرنا, وأحسن خلاصنا. اللهم تقبل منا, وعلى طاعتك أعنا, ومن شرور خلقك سلمنا, ومن فضلك لا تحرمنا, وعافنا واعف عنا. آمين آمين آمين. وصل اللهم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين, وأقم الصلاة.